Learn how to make this Apple-like onboarding slash new update feature screen in SwiftUI. To get started, I have a pretty much empty project here. It does have an app icon. I can show you that real quick here in the assets. And other than that, it's pretty much the blank startup project. The only thing that I changed is that instead of showing the content view here right in the preview, I'm actually showing it as a sheet in the preview. All right, so I have a constant binding of true, so this sheet is just always shown. Every time that the preview refreshes, basically it will be automatically shown. And then inside of that sheet, I just have the content view, which right now only has a text saying hello world, so pretty much empty, but we'll get to that onboarding screen from the Apple apps in just a second. I have set it to be dark mode just because the screenshot that I showed you earlier is also in dark mode, but of course this works exactly the same way in light and dark mode as we're just using the system colors. I also recommend you to watch until the end, because in the end we will make this reusable, so it works pretty much automatically for all of your apps and you don't have to manually change stuff around. Let's get rid of that text in the body and let's get started. So we will get started by creating a VStack here. Inside of that VStack, we will have four elements. We will have our app icon at the top. Then we will have a text saying welcome to app name. Then we will have a grid of all of the new features, or like a list of all of the new features. And then we will have a continue button at the bottom. So let's start with that app icon at the top. And that is actually super easy using a tiny bit of UI kit, but really it's pretty much Swift UI only. So for that, let's say we will create an image, but we will create it from a UI image. Now you see the thing is that we have our app icon here, but we can't actually use that in Swift UI. We will have to create a UI image using that app icon, and we will have to use the named initializer here. And then we can say the name is app icon. Now this is unfortunately optional, but since the app does have an app icon, we can force unwrap it. Another solution would be to provide an alternative here. Now waiting for just a second here, you will see that the app icon shows up, but it's very small for some reason, even though it's a 1024 by 1024 image file. Because of that, we will just make it resizable. First of all, make it scale to fit and give it a frame with a width and a height of 64 each. That should already be a much better size. And then I will also say we will give this a clip shape of a rounded rectangle. Let's press option here so we get both the corner radius and the style. For the corner radius, let's say 16. For the style, let's say continuous. That will give it that squircle shape, I would call it. Rounded corners with a nice transition into the edges here. Okay, so now that we have the app icon in place, let's continue with the text. So the text should say, welcome to my app. And once again, I will show you how to make this reusable at the end of the video. So stick around until the end. And then we will give this a large title font, font of large title. And we will also give this a font weight of semi-bold, so it sticks out a bit more. All right, just like that. Okay, and now for the interesting section, the new features that your app might have. That is basically like a list, but we will not be using the SwiftUI list. Instead, we will be using the SwiftUI grid to nicely align all of the images and all of the text beneath each other. So let's get started by creating a grid view. And inside of that, we will have different grid rows. Each of these rows will have two columns, one column for the image and one column for all of the text. So let's create our first grid row here. And the first column is just our image. Now from the example, I'll just take some of the example images and copy from the screenshot that I showed you earlier. So the image will be one of cloud. We will give it a font size of title. Now remember that these SF symbols actually respect your font sizes that you give them, so we don't have to specify a size by points. I prefer it this way because it automatically scales with the device's font size. And then we'll also give this a foreground color. You can either say blue, or you can just use the app's accent color, which is blue by default. Okay, next up, let's create a VStack with an alignment and a spacing actually. So let's just hold option here. Alignment is leading and spacing is 8 points. And then in here, first of all, there's the text for the title. And then right beneath that, there's a text for the feature description. So let me just copy these over really quick. Okay, so now that we have both of these strings in place, let's style it a tiny bit. So the top one will be our headline. The bottom one is the description. And instead of changing the font size, I will just say the foreground color should be secondary. Let's make it, that makes it not stand out that much. And I think this looks really close to what the Apple screenshot looks like. Okay, this is pretty much what we wanted. Let's now just make sure that all of these spacings here are correct. And for that, we can go into the grid and we can say horizontal and vertical spacing. Let's set both of them to 16 points. We already have that content closure back here. And now we can just take this grid row, copy it and paste it two more times. And now we have three new features here. In addition to that, let's also give the entire grid a padding to the top. So let's say padding to the top edge, just like that, so it's not sticking to this welcome to my app text up here. Okay, and then the last UI element is a continue button. Now we will have to play around with the alignment a bit because we want this section here to be more or less vertically centered, but we want the button to be at the bottom. So what we will do is put a spacer above and in between the grid and the button. So let's create a spacer here at the bottom and let's add a spacer at the top as well. And then below the bottom spacer, right now it looks exactly the same. We will add a button with the string continue. We'll handle this action in just a second and we'll give it a button style of border prominent. Just makes it have the accent color as a background in a rounded rectangle. Okay, so what should this action do? It should just close the sheet. So for that, there's an environment variable that we can use and it's called dismiss. And this is actually a closure that we can call. So we'll just pass that in here as the content of our button action. Now in the preview, this will not work because the binding to show the sheet in the preview is a constant being set to true. And this is pretty much the exact setup if you just want to use this in one of your apps, but we want to make it reusable, so stick around right now. I have prepared a little snippet here that we can use to make this my app string completely automatic. And for that, we will create a new computed variable. So I will call this app name. This will be a string. And as I said, it will be a computed variable. And I'm just gonna paste this thing in here because it's ugly to type out. So basically we're using the app bundle, the main bundle that has an info dictionary with a bunch of strings as keys. Now being type safe, we will use this old Objective-C KCF bundle name key constant. And then as you can see, all of this is optional stuff. So in the end, we will just optionally change this to no app name. Right now it's obviously not showing. So let's replace the my app hard-coded string here, use string interpolation and use our computed variable up here. And then we can see welcome to reusable onboarding because that's just the name of the app that I created here. It might look a bit nicer if we give this a center multiline text alignment. So on this text here, let's say multiline text alignment, set this to center and you can see it's nice and centered. So that's the first step of making it reusable. Our app icon is already reusable. And then the third step is to make these features here reusable. And for that, we will create a new struct. I will call this onboarding feature. Let's make this identifiable so we can use the SwiftUI for each view. In order for it to be identifiable, we need to create a UUID and set that to our ID property. We don't care about this, but SwiftUI just needs it for each to work. And then each of these features has an image, a title, and a description associated with them. So let's say we have a system image, which is a string. We have a title, which is a string, and we have a description, which is also a string. And then into our content view, we will pass an array of onboarding features and we will then use them instead of our previously existing grid rows. So right below the dismiss action, we will say, let features be an array of onboarding feature. Now this will not compile because we have to add onboarding features to our preview. So let's fix that. And I'm not sure where this comma came from. And then in here, we can just create the feature that we basically already had. So the system name was called Cloud. Let's copy over this title as well. And let's also copy over the description. Now, of course, this is something that you would create in your app, customized to your app. This is the only thing you will need to set up. Okay, and then the next step is to actually use this in our view. So we will get rid of the bottom two grid rows. And we will take the first grid row, embed it in a for each. Let's say all of the features. Okay, and then we can grab our feature in this closure here. And then instead of these hard-coded strings, we can just say feature.systemImage, feature.title, and feature.description. And just like that, it looks exactly the same in the preview. Let's give this a build real quick. It's probably inside of the app struct. We also have to add these features here. So I will just do it like that. Okay, now the preview should work again. And you will see it looks pretty much exactly the same, but now this content view here is absolutely reusable. So you could rename this to your onboarding screen, for example, and then just use this in all of your projects. You will just have to set the list of features, and the app icon and the app name will get extracted automatically. And of course, the continue button also works. I hope you learned something in this video, and if you plan to continue using SwiftUI and want to learn more about advanced features and techniques, subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!